Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the components for data generation and anonymization from within the SSIS Productivity Pack. The SSIS Productivity Pack is a collection of premium SSIS components which enable greater developer productivity and increases the power of SSIS. As of this recording, the SSIS Productivity Pack offers two data flow components, Data Spawner and Data Anonymizer. These components are for the specific task of data generation and anonymization. The Data Spawner component is a source component that can be used to generate random sample data. The Data Anonymizer component is a transformation component that can be used to mask data so that you can use it to protect sensitive data when sending or moving the data to a new environment. For the purpose of this demonstration, we will begin with a data spawner first. Later on, we will show you how to configure the data anonymizer component. Let's start by dragging the data spawner from the SSIS toolbox to the data flow design surface. Double-click it to bring up its editor form. As mentioned before, the data spawner is a source component that generates random data. The number of rows to spawn option allows you to specify the number of rows to generate data for. Within this grid, you can add or remove columns by clicking on the applicable buttons. As an example, I will start to add a couple of columns here. To configure the column properties, select a column within the grid. Once a column is selected, you will find its properties window, which details how the sample data is generated. There are a number of spawn types to choose from, including first name, last name, email, and many more as you can see here. Click OK to finish configuring this data spawner component. For this demonstration, we are going to add a dummy data reader destination component for the purpose of showing you how the data flows from the source to destination components. In order to see the data in between, we are going to add a data viewer so that when we run the data flow task, we can see the data from the source component. We will now execute the task. As you can see, we've got records back from the data spawner source. These records have all been generated randomly to provide us with sample data to work with, based on the criteria we've chosen in the data spawner component. We will now focus on the data anonymizer component. As mentioned before, this data anonymizer component is a transformation component for the purpose of masking data from upstream data flow components. To get started, let us first create a connection manager to a source component to read data from. In our example, I will create a connection manager to Dynamics CRM. Please note that the connection manager that we just created is a package-level connection manager. For SSIS 2012 or later, you can create project-level connection managers if you right-click the connection manager's node within the Solution Explorer. Let's start by dragging the CRM source component from the SSIS toolbox to the data flow design surface. I will quickly configure the CRM source component to read data from the contact entity for three specific fields, first name, last name, and email. Click OK to finish configuring the source component. The next step is to drag the data anonymizer component from the SSIS toolbox to our design surface. Connect the source to this transformation component. Double-click the Data Anonymizer component to open its editor form. Here, you will see the columns from your upstream source components, and you can configure how you would like to have each column anonymized. Select a column to specify its columns property on the right side of the grid. The anonymization type allows you to choose an anonymous type, which dictates how the data is anonymized. We can now navigate to the error handling page, where there are three error handling mechanisms to choose from. The default option is fail and error, where the entire data flow will fail as soon as an error occurs. There is also the redirect rows to error output, where the error output would contain the failed records with extra columns, error code, error column, and error message. There is also a third option, which is to ignore any errors that may have occurred. Click OK to finish configuring this data anonymizer component. We are now going to add dummy data reader destination components for the purpose of showing you how the data flows from the source to transformation components. In order to see the data in between, we are going to enable data viewers so that when we run the data flow task, we can see the data from the transformation component. We will now execute the task. As you can see, the data reader on the left is from CRM. On the right, the data anonymizer component has successfully processed the incoming records by masking the relevant fields. This concludes the demonstration of our data spawner and data anonymizer components within our SSIS productivity pack. There are many other components in the SSIS productivity pack that enable developers to accomplish more in SSIS in a much more productive fashion. Please feel free to take a look at our other videos available for viewing on our website or YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video. For any additional questions, please feel free to reach out to us.